Right, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I want to give my disclaimer. That is, I'm not a financial advisor. I have no idea about economics or anything like that, and these videos should be taken completely, totally and utterly for entertainment purposes only. All right, so first of all as well, secondly, this video is not DJ related. It's basically about what's going on around the world. And if you have indeed been living in a box for the past couple of years, what's happened is there's been loads more fiat currency just thrown into the system, which is why we have inflation, because there's too much currency after less goods and services. But anyway, put that to one side, and I've got a theory here. And again, this is just my little theory. Now, at the moment, well, no, actually, let's go back 20, 30, 40, 50 years, doesn't matter. But if you had, let's say, for example, in the US, the UK, France, Germany, say if you had 5 Deutschmarks, 5 francs, $5, 5 pounds, in other words, you got 5 of something. Actually, let's make it easy, around 10. So around 10 of your currency, wherever you are around the world, you had 10 of them. You could buy X amount of goods and services for that currency. Now, if you have the same 10, okay, we don't have the franc because now we have the euro, what you will find is you can now buy less. So for example, with those 10, if you just wanted to buy milk, cheese, tobacco, condoms, budgie gas, anything. No, imagine, oh, sorry, mate, you can only have half a budgie now. Sorry about that. Bread van. No, 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 no. Anyway, anyone who gets that, leave a comment. So, what I'm getting at here is that the money supply, as it increases, causes inflation. And over the past couple of years, we have seen a dramatic increase in the money supply, hence we have inflation. Now, the trouble is, if we go to what's known as hyperinflation, that's when you need a vast amount of currency to buy a minimum amount of goods and services. And as hyperinflation grows, the more currency you need to buy the same amount you would have bought the day before, 2 days, a month ago. But now let's imagine, all of a sudden, if the monetary system physically collapses. Now, the reason for this video is to get your head around this. At the moment, we live in this society where we base goods and services, products, houses, watches, cars, phones, as a value based on fiat currency. So for example, you know, you buy a phone, a brand new iPhone, and you will have to give them a certain amount of your currency for that telephone. But then let's imagine all that falls apart and the currency is no longer has value, your fiat currency. How do you buy that? How do you buy the phone? Not only that, how do you base the value of that phone based on the fact that the fiat currency you're using, or all fiat currencies, have now just gone into oblivion? Well, you see, this is where we go back to what used to happen many, many years ago, is you would do something for someone and they would do something for you in return. Now, that's fine if you've got chickens and someone's got a loaf of bread because they're a baker. You can swap, half a dozen eggs for a loaf of bread. But you can't exactly do that with a big company for an iPhone. So this is the scary bit. What would happen, not will, I don't know, it might, what will happen if we get to that position where fiat currencies as we know them are now worthless and they've gone, they've vanished. Now, pre-1971, we had what's known as the gold standard, and you could go into any central bank around the world and you could exchange $35 thereabouts, or the equivalent in your currency, for an ounce of gold. But I believe in America, it was illegal to have gold. Then after 71, up to about 75, there was a window where you could indeed go and buy gold out of a bank. But then sure enough, the gold started to disappear, and the banks didn't like that. So I believe that, again, I'm not knowledgeable on all history, but I believe that's what happened. But now you see, an ounce of gold is about $1,750. Whereas if you look at the USdebtClock.org, you'll find that based on the current climate and how much debt is out there, an ounce of gold should be $35,000 or thereabouts. So perhaps we could go back to a currency backed by gold. Now, if you're familiar with the BRICS nations, they are China, Russia, there's India, I believe South America, loads of other countries. Well, they are seriously considering having gold as one of the forms of, or one of the metals to back their currency. Now, if that happens, let's say, for example, they decide that an ounce of gold is worth $3,500. What will happen is half the world will be thinking, hold on a minute, the price of gold is $1,700, yet China and Japan are willing to pay us $3,500. Where do you think all the gold's going to go? And then a lot of the rest of the world won't have any. Now, I have digressed there slightly, but back to the subject, and that is that, how will you base something's value? Base it on what? We've all been so used to, in our lifetimes, practically every single person watching this video would have only been brought up having the dollar as the world reserve, currency, and using their currency wherever they are around the world. But if the dollar fails, then who knows? So please, in a comment, I'm sure there are people far more knowledgeable than I am, but I'm just putting my pennies worth out there. And I'll finish the video with this, okay? Now, fiat currencies, especially the dollar, the pound, euro, are actually backed by nothing. They've got nothing physical behind them. So what you're using, and the only reason you're able to use that, is because everyone else uses it. As soon as, if it does happen, there's panic, more inflation, 10, 20, 30, 50, 1,000%, then people will finally realize that the paper they're using isn't even worth, or the ink isn't even worth the paper it's written on, if that makes sense. And that's when people will go back to real hard assets, commodities, you know, and that's when you will probably see bartering for, you know, a gallon of water for a loaf of bread, and so on. Anyway, I'll finish the video with one last subject. I think that the future of where to put your money and where to invest is water. Now, that sounds bizarre, because most people, you turn your tap on, there it is. But just hear me out. Think about it, do your research, and you may find that water could be one of the most important, well, it is anyway, one of the most important, valuable commodities in the future. Practice and enjoy. Thank you very much.